As camera technology continues to grow from HD to 8K resolutions and beyond, the challenge of distributing these massive amounts of media grow greater. Enter Red Digital Cinema and MediaMonks, two companies who collaborated to bring a Post Malone concert to VR headsets in stunning clarity with almost no latency. Join us as we go all in on how these early adopters are building a new cloud-centric distribution model from the ground up.
Uday, thanks for taking the time to explain to us a little bit about the involvement of Red Connect and the Post Malone concert. Could you tell us a little bit more about that workflow and how Red integrated?
Sure. So our customer, MediaMonks, came to us looking for a solution for live AR and XR. And that solution depends on many parts of the Red ecosystem. It starts with an 8K sensor. And on top of that 8K sensor, we put a special dual fisheye lens. So you can capture a left eye view and a right eye view, both in 4K. The next challenge is getting that live view processed for AR VR viewing. So we actually offload the footage live to a GPU where we generate a dewarped image that's recompressed and uploaded to the cloud for distribution.
But tell me a little bit about how is this different than, say, a traditional workflow for this?
So a few years ago when we were doing similar workflows, it was all file-based, and you would actually record a left camera and a right camera, pull footage from both cameras, and then offline process it, maybe in a data center or maybe on local GPUs. But it wasn't a live workflow. It wasn't the type of thing that you can enjoy as the event is happening. It was more something that you'd see if you wanted to relive the event in AR or XR after the fact. By going to a connected workflow and interfacing directly to the GPU, we took what used to be an after the event and made it a live streaming.
Wow, so that latency then becomes really impactful to be able to do that as a live stream. Tell me, how do you actually get the network bandwidth to make that happen?
So there are a few key parts of technology that let us actually use just a simple 10 gigabit Ethernet to move Red code raw from the camera to the GPU for full processing. The GPU does the dewarping on the stream as it's coming in live in real time, and then recompresses it so that our partner can uplink that footage to the cloud and then distribute it.
Really great. So tell me a little bit about, as you're taking that imagery in the GPU, what are you actually doing in that dewarping process?
It's a pretty straightforward dewarping of a fisheye lens to an equirectangular view to make it suitable for both a left eye and a right eye view of the headset. And by doing this in real time and live, you can actually show a separate left view and right view to a headset viewer so that they feel immersed in the experience.
Is there a way that I could experience that headset?
I believe you can. I believe we have some hardware here that you can try out.
Fantastic. Oh, this is really cool. Oh, I can totally like see different experiences all around me, and then there's actually somebody over there. I feel like I'm watching the concert with someone.
Mm-hmm.
So tell me, as I'm doing this, how many different camera shots would this have taken?
So the strange thing is this entire immersive view is taken from a single camera position.
Really?
Yeah, it's a...
It's phenomenal.
The high resolution of the sensor lets you see the fine detail wherever you're looking.
Oh, that is what's really phenomenal, is it actually feels like it's really here. And I know that I'm probably looking all over the place, but it is really neat that it feels like it's everywhere.
Uploading these large files to the cloud is a huge feat, but it's only half the story. Now it's time for MediaMonks to step in to edit, package, and deliver the final project in 8K quality.
Post Malone's 12-carat Toothache in VR was a project that was shot with multiple Red Raptor XLs that were custom modified specifically for the production of VR. The original plan was we were going to ship out drives to our editors in Europe. Our editor, myself, actually here, I was gonna edit in this room here in Raleigh, North Carolina. We were gonna back up to, it was like 3 or 4 RAIDs. We were gonna be golden, we were gonna be ready to go. At the time, I had seen this product called a snow cone, an AWS snow cone advertised. So what's great about working with a snowball or a snow cone is once your stuff is up on S3, it's backed up across multiple local zones. It goes into glacial or even deep glacial, like we used on this particular project as well. And it counts as multiple viable redundant backups. A drive would be left in Los Angeles. Another drive would be shipped back to me, North Carolina. And the third backup would head on out to Amsterdam. Got home the next day, a big hard plastic case shows up on my doorstep. I pick it up and it starts jingling like there's a metal puzzle inside. Another fun factor here is that weekend and that coming week was the week of my wedding anniversary. So I was getting ready to tell my wife that we were gonna spend our wedding week in a romantic edit suite with no windows in Amsterdam. And wasn't that gonna be great? When one of the team members suggested, hey, it's up on S3. We just work with it on S3. And why don't we engage with that? Now look, if the editor needs to work with you on cuts in person so you have that ability to vibe back and forth, why doesn't he just come to you? And if you need to access RAW, you can just pull it down from the cloud. No problem at all. And we said, you know what? Let's try it. Let's do that. And so we did. We started editing at 9 a.m. on Monday, so 2 days after leaving set, or 2 or 3 days after set, and we delivered to all of our deadlines on time. The team was able to work around a global, around-the-clock, 24-hour-a-day schedule to get our shots done on time, where there's a lot of skepticism in the media and entertainment industry around new technology. We're usually not curing cancer. Actually, we almost always are not. And the people who actually are using the cloud. The people who run the global banking systems, all of that stuff, medical systems, aviation systems, all in fact run on the cloud. So why is it good enough for them but not good enough for us? It works and it's functional, and we were able to deliver in VR at 8K at 60 frames a second, a project built almost completely on the cloud for post-production on time without skipping a beat.
The demand for quick turnarounds with massive file sizes are not going away anytime soon. Together, Red and MediaMonks leverage cloud-based workflows and realize cost-saving efficiencies for large-scale media productions. As the cloud changes the economics of productions, continuous innovations drive the media and entertainment industry forward.